Hi friends, today we are going to discuss about the iris flower production by using the machine learning. Here we are going to execute the in deployment section. So here we have to identify the different types of the flowers. So here setosa is one kind of flower, and versicolor is one kind of flower, and virginica is one kind of flower. So here this is the three classes. So it means it is the multi-class classification problem. So these four attributes belong to this is to call the features or attributes, measurements and dimensions. So here these are the observations from start from 1 to 50, 100. So here first 50 observations belong to setosa, and 51 to 100 belong to versicolor, and 101 to 150 belong to this virginica. So the flowers, how can you measure these values? So here the input values in the in the form of centimeters. So here the sepal length can be measured, like sepal length. This is the sepal length, and this is the sepal width, and this is the petal length and petal width. So by using this kind of measurements, we have to identify the flower belongs to either setosa or versicolor or virginica. So if you see here, so this setosa is looks like this setosa flower. So it will be look like this, and versicolor will be looks like this, and virginica will be looks like this. If you comes to this execution, so here our problem statement is create the model. So that model has to classify the different species of the iris flower. So iris is the family in the flower, so which contain the three species, which are the setosa, versicolor and virginica. So now I'm executing this libraries. So this is the data set looks like. So here my target variable is the species, is contain the three different kinds of the flowers, setosa, versicolor, virginica. So if you apply the value commands 50 50 50, so setosa belongs to 50, versicolor 50, virginica 50, and shape is totally 150 rows. And this contains the null values. There is no null values. So here I'm dividing the x and y. And here our target variable is the categorical variable. So that's why we are applying the label encoding. So if you apply the label encoding, what will happen? So it will assign the 0. So it may setosa will be assigned to 0. It will be assigned to 1, and it will be assigned to 2. So if you execute the y means target variable. So first 50 observations belongs to the setosa, and next 51 observations, which are in value 1, is the versicolor, and rest of the 50, so it is repeated with the number 2, is the virginica. So I am importing the dividing the data with 80-20% training testing, apply the model, make the prediction, evaluate the model. So my SVC classification given the accuracy is 93. So applying the confusion matrix. So here there is a two values are wrongly predicted. So rest of the 9 and 8, 11 is correctly predicted. So this is the classification report. It is given the 93%. So here I will import the model by using the pickle file. So here I'm predicting the value. So I'm giving the input values here. So my model predicted value 2. If you comes to deployment section, so deployment section, so my data, so my file will be, so this is my file. So this file contain the, this file I can imported here. So this file will be displayed here. So this is my model. So this is the model we discussed in the Jupyter till now. So this is the application file, and this is my data set, and this is the pickle file, and this is the templates. So templates contain the some HTML pages, web pages. So here I'm executing the first model. So this is the model file, is contain the this model file is the contain the code for the machine learning model to predict the target variable. So based on the our training data set. So first I will execute this model file. So here our model got the so predicted as 2. So now I'm executing a app dot py. So here app dot py contain the flask API. So the flask API, what it will be doing, so it will receive the input variables, it will receive the input variables through the API, so application program interface. So here computes the predicted values, so based on our model. So our model was be built here by using the file name is model.py. So here we are build the model by using the support vector classifier. So it will be interact by using the app. So we have to importing the pickle file here, read the pickle file. So this is our data set. So I'm executing the app file. So here it will be executed without any errors. Then we have to go anaconda prompt. So here you can go to the directory. So where is our directory? So first here go to this so this all files will be in this directory. You can copy this directory link and change the directory. So here python dot, so what is our model name? So model.py, model.py. So see, it will be executed as 2, and python.app.py. So it will be generated one kind of URL. So this is the URL, the flask server on the local host, it will be displayed with this URL. So you can copy this URL and go to the browser. So open this paste this link. So you will get the values. So here you can enter this value 6.3 3.3. So 6.3 3.3 and 6.0 2.5 predict. So this is the virginica. So virginica means what here? So virginica means 2. That's why your target variable will be, you got the output 2. Suppose if you go to the home page, you can enter this any value. For example, you can give this values 5.1 3.5 1.4 0.2. let's say our model will predicted either setosa or not. So 5.1 3.5 1.4 0.2 setosa. So if enter another value 7.0 3.2 4.7 1.4. So versicolor, this is the another type of the flower. And if you go another kind of a data set, 6.3 3.3 6.0 and 2.5. so this is virginica. So So this is the way you can able to deploy your model. I hope you like this project. Thank you.